So hi, it's Karina Gordon-Barnes of youinspireme.co.uk and I'm here today with Siobhan Costello of greatbusinessresults.co.uk and we are talking about being memorable when it comes to networking. Hey Siobhan.
Hi Karina, how are you doing?
Hey, really good, thank you. And this is such a great topic to start off the new year with because lots of people I think have been networking their socks off last year, maybe for years, and certainly for me, I didn't feel memorable when I used to go to networking events. Even though I'm an extrovert, you know, even though I would be chatting happily away, I couldn't find a way to stand out. Tell me about what networking used to be like for you.
Well, when I started, I was pretty appalling at it, really, because I just didn't get it. I didn't understand it. I didn't know what it was all about. There was no training for the groups that I was going to. And I found it really scary. I came from a background where I chaired large meetings. You know, I was in, you know, sort of high profile roles. But my God, walking into a network meeting and having to stand up and do to talk for 60 seconds about my business was terrifying. And I worried a lot about it, about how I was coming across. I was supposed to be a confident woman, you know, I was supposed to be dealing with all of these particular issues. And yet I felt a complete wobble every time I walked over the threshold of a network meeting.
Yeah. And you've gone from that. And I believe you kind of just, at one point you stopped networking because it was so unpleasant. Like for many, many people, they stop it.
It came to the point where I thought I actually don't know what I'm doing here. I'm spending money on it, and yet I'm not getting anything back from my networking. Yeah. So I was making an investment, and yet nothing was happening for me. And I had a tendency to blame the network group, when in actual fact it wasn't about that. You know, I was fearful of the competition that was in the room. And I remember once being there with, at the time I was doing hypnotherapy, and I remember once being at one of the meetings, and there was another hypnotherapist in the room. She had obviously got to know everybody, and I was the new girl on the block. And it was really interesting how that competition just stopped me functioning in any sort of adult level. And what actually brought it to what we eventually did was we sat down and we talked. And that was all it was a matter of doing, was sitting down and saying, you know, we're together here. How does this work? And I can talk about some tips, but what we did in that situation was to decide on who was pitching what each particular time we were in the room. So am I doing stress management today and you're doing stop smoking? I think that was that, and that was a real turning point for me to realize that actually this wasn't about competition. This was all about collaboration and relationship building. And once I knew that, I thought, this is what I do. This is what I love. I love building relationships, communication with people. I don't do competition, so I don't really, it doesn't make me feel comfortable.
And you've now so gone on to actually, you now actually run how many networking events now?
8 groups.
Yeah. So it's like from hating it to actually running. So you run the Women in Business Network in the East Anglia region. For anyone who's in East Anglia, you can go to Siobhan's networking events. And you're going to be guest speaker at our upcoming You Inspire Me networking event, which we'll talk about in a bit. So when it comes to being memorable, how is someone going to remember you? What could someone do before and during and after a networking event to be memorable? Let's start with the before.
Yeah, so I wanted to give you some really key tips today so that people who are starting the networking can really, you know, start to implement these straight away. Okay. And if you think about before you go to a meeting, even if it's informal and if it's formal, my advice is to contact the person who runs the network group and ask them, can they send you a list of the people who are going to the meeting? And that means that you then have an idea as to who it is that you want to speak to when you get there. So rather than going into the meeting and having no plan or a scattergun approach of I'm going to speak to everybody, go in through the door having looked at the list and saying to yourself, there are two or three key people on this list that if I talk to them, it would be helpful in terms of either collaboration or referral partners or possibility of passing clients between each other, you know, or maybe I might be able to talk to them about what I do in some way in depth that might help my business. Mm. So therefore, you're making yourself memorable to the owner of the network.
Yes.
I love people do that.
Yes, I do. I love it.
Yeah, it just makes me, they stand out from the crowd as somebody who's really thinking strategically about the next 2 hours they're going to spend in my group.
Yes.
And I love that. I want to be able to help them and make sure that they get what they want.
Yes.
Because they put thought into their goal for that meeting.
Yes.
So, and not only that, I think it also means that the people that this person walks up to and says, I spotted your name on the list. I've had a look at your website. I really want to have a chat with you, just really because I think there may be some synergies between us. That's really powerful to somebody who's there going, oh, gosh, she's looked at my website before I've even met her.
Yes, yeah.
You know.
Yeah, beautiful. I love that. So it's like deciding in advance who do you want to be memorable to and then taking the action, actually leaning into the organizer of that group as someone who can do that, who can facilitate that, whether it's through a list. For my group, we have a Facebook event in advance so people can see names, websites in advance. Yeah. And it's not just the 2 hours you're going to be there, it's some preparation time as well.
Yeah,
great.
Yeah, absolutely.
So now we're at the event. How can we, let's say there's, you know, 20, 50, 100 people there, how can we be memorable in a really authentic way? Because I'm sure we could do things that are inauthentic, you know, till the cows come home. But to be really true to ourselves, how can we be memorable when we get in the room?
Well, I think this connects with what I was saying beforehand, is being prepared and seeing who it is you want to speak to, because that makes it more of an effective use of your time. But, of course, at a meeting like that, you probably have an opportunity to give a pitch, a memorable pitch. I like to call the 60-second pitch a memorable minute, because it just changes the feeling you get about it. It's about making yourself memorable in somebody's mind. It's not a pitch about your business. It's about making you as a person memorable to people.
Yeah.
So, and how you might do that. And even if, like at your meeting, Karina, we don't necessarily stand up to the whole group and give a 60-second pitch, but it is that those 3 minutes when we talk to each other that we have that opportunity to be able to say something.
Yeah.
So there are a few people on my network who I like to use as an example about how they make themselves memorable in ways that are authentic to them. Now, I like to start with sometimes like a question to say, I'm Siobhan Costello from Great Business Results. And who do you know who says, I haven't managed to meet all my goals last year? And I then would then say, if you know somebody like that, please refer them to me.
Mm-hmm.
Or I might say, maybe I'm going in looking for somebody who, I'm being specific, and that's really the key.
Yes.
So I might say, today I'm looking for women who are over 50, who have just started up a business and are looking to grow that business.
It does what I call the missing persons thing, the kind of Pavlov, like, you know, the Pavlov and the kind of dogs salivating and the food. It's like, oh, that rings a bell. Yes, I know that person. It's like, really, like, this is the missing person. Have you seen this person? Yeah. And it's that specificity, so important.
It just clicks with people.
Yeah.
Rather than saying, I'm a therapist and I'm looking for people who want to lose weight and stop smoking, you know, two of the key goals over the new year. If you were to say, I help people over 40 to lose a stone in weight, who do you know who woke up on the 1st of January saying, this is the day I'm going to lose weight, I'm going to start my weight loss, and they're over 40 and they want to lose one stone? So you might get a whole load of other people, but actually you've been specific. And the added thing to that is to make yourself stand out from the crowd as well. Now, I'm not a jokey person. I don't like to tell jokes or sing songs when I do the pitches or write poems. It's just not me. I can't do it. And I don't put myself through that trauma. But here's a couple of examples of what people do. So I know a woman, I'm going to use a name of a company. She calls herself the business plumber. And she doesn't do any of that smart stuff either. What she does is she comes with a plunger tool. You know, brilliant. A plunger?
Yeah, brilliant.
And says, I'm Kate, the business plumber, and she holds up the tool. And it's amazing, the experience, because everybody laughs and they remember her.
Yes.
And the other person is who comes to mind is a virtual assistant.
Yes.
Who brings a teacup and a saucer. And she says, I help you to have your 11 o'clock tea break with ease and peace of mind. She frees up your time. Yeah.
Oh, I love it. And it is just as simple as that. You have remembered them to give examples right now, right?
Yeah.
We know now the business plumber, we can go and look her up. And it's like, how are you going to remember this person? There's got to be something that's specific, that it has a interest, a hook of some kind. They're great, great examples.
Yeah. And asking a question when you start, you know, who do you know? Or a very clear statement that says, this month I'm looking for, and then straight into that very specific person.
Yeah.
It just focuses everybody's attention on what it is that you want.
Yeah. And asking for what you want, right? That's so
asking.
I love that. Just, you know, this is what I want, and I'm going to ask for it. I'm going to ask for it before from the organizer. I'm going to ask for it during. And then afterwards, how can we stay memorable once the, you know, cups have been drunk and the biscuits or the green smoothies have been drunk?
Well, I mean, this is all about the follow-up after the meeting. And I think everybody who goes networking does the standard thing. They connect on LinkedIn and Facebook and Twitter. And I would really encourage everybody to do that after your meeting. Make sure you connect with those people in that way. I also like to send an email to people to say, hi, Karina, it was great to see you at the meeting. I really enjoyed talking to you. And if there was something specific that we talked about, to mention that in the email. Yeah. Or if I looked at your website, I might say, oh, gosh, I particularly liked your website. And you wrote this blog about X, and I really like the blog. I mean, being sincere about it, you know, you don't want to talk about stuff that you aren't really interested in. But generally, I like to follow up and have a look at what people have been doing and connect in some way with them on a personal level. Yeah. And I think as well, there are sometimes key people that it's really worth just picking up the telephone to. Mm. So this isn't a cold call. It's not a sales call. It's nothing of that nature. It's just saying, I want to make that extra connection. And it feels right to lift up the phone and say, you know, hi, Karina. We talked for like, 2 minutes, 3 minutes. It was a great meeting, wasn't it? But really, I felt there was something else that I wanted to, you know, I thought we might be able to talk a bit more. Do you fancy having 15 minutes on Skype or on the telephone just to have a chat about it, see if there's any synergy or collaboration? And I think that just makes you just that little bit more personal in what you do and your approach.
And with such widespread use of social media, that is now the difference. Like when email came in, writing a letter was the thing. Now that social media is what we all do, then email or phone calls can be the thing of actually standing out from the crowd in that way and being memorable. And I love that then, you know, when that networking event finishes, it's like that was the opening act. That wasn't, you've got to get everything done and dusted and, you know, be known within that time. You've got so much opportunity afterwards to stoke the fires of those connections that were made.
Yeah. And that's all about setting that networking goal, isn't it? It's about understanding why is it that you're going to expend your precious time on going to these meetings, if not to create a journey afterwards, you know, relationship with people afterwards.
Yeah.
Not with everybody, because it's not possible to do that. So it is really, it does start before you even come through the door, thinking, who are the specific people who it would really be useful for me to just make contact with and to follow up with afterwards. Yeah. And that way you just, you make yourself memorable, not pushy.
Yes.
And it feels right for you, you know. Don't do what's not right for you. Yeah. And I don't pick up the telephone to anybody. I pick up the telephone to people whom I feel I had a rapport with,
yeah.
You know. So it's not cold calling. It's very much like I felt I had a moment in which we had a bit more of a significant connection, yeah. You know.
I love it. I love how this lights you up. You and I both share this passion for networking, bringing people together and seeing what happens when people get a chance to communicate.
Yeah.
So you're going to be taking the stage at the You Inspire Me community meetup on...
I'm very excited.
I'm very excited. You've obviously been along as a participant and you know what to expect. And for you watching, it's happening on Wednesday, the 18th of February. It's in central London. And Siobhan, can you give us any little kind of sneak preview of what we can expect at that event that we might walk away with? What we're going to discover from you in that talk that you're going to be giving in the middle of the networking event?
Yeah, well, I want to give some really useful information. So I'm going to be looking at the key mistakes that people make when they network,
yeah.
And what it is that makes it doesn't feel right and it's not comfortable for them. They don't feel congruent with it and it turns them off going back. So I want to look a bit more closely at that. But I also want to be able to give people a way to say, if I go along to this event, can I predict in some way what sort of number of clients I'm going to get from it? So I'm going to look at that as well and hopefully give people food for thought around how you can actually consistently calculate the number of clients you would get from a particular event. And then I want to work a little bit on the monthly minute, the memorable minute.
Wonderful.
Just to give a bit more of a teaser about it, because it's actually great fun when you actually get into the whole idea of it.
Yeah, fantastic. You've made it fun. It does. It sounds very different from the 60-second pitch, which for so many people is like, oh, no. So the link is just here below that you can book your ticket. They do often go very fast. So do book and come and see us in London on Wednesday in February. So Siobhan, what would you like people to leave a comment about below? One thing that I would like is I would love to hear what it is people are looking for when they go to networking events. So, you know, kind of a chance in the comments here to practice, you know, this month I'm looking for, what is it? Practice here and then you can do it when you go to a networking event. Anything that you would like them to, you invite them to write there.
Yeah, I mean, I would like to hear how they feel about networking. You know, what are their concerns about networking? Mm-hmm. So if people could put in their top two concerns about that they might have about networking, then hopefully I can start to sort of work that in to help them when I give the talk, really. You know, that would be useful information. And I'd like to hear some of your stories as well about, you know, what your experiences have been when you're networking too.
Yeah, what's been the, you were talking earlier about someone who takes a rubber chicken underneath his arm to networking events.
Yeah, the Will Ryder who stands on the chair because he's a short guy. He stands on the chair and he takes out of his briefcase a puppet and he does the whole 60-second pitch through the puppet.
Oh my gosh.
And he stands on the chair because he's short, because nobody can see him. That's one of the happy memories I have, and that's what I love about it, really. It's full of really great material because, you know, people are all very individual, aren't they?
Yeah, I love it. So lots of exciting stories to appear below. Thank you so much, Siobhan, for being here. You can find more about Siobhan at greatbusinessresults.co.uk, and we'll see you in February. Thank you and bye for now.
Thanks a lot, Karina.